Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Unfortunately, I cannot be present here. Let me introduce myself. My name is Andriy Kasyanenko. I am a postgraduate student. I will present the work which I have done with my colleagues from Donetsk National Technical University, Faculty of Mining, Mineral Deposits, Engineering Department, Donetsk, Ukraine. This work studies floor heaving in the mine working of a coal mine by way of example at a Bakuo mine. Firstly, I'd like to describe the mine conditions when floor heaving happens. After that, I'd like to explain how this problem has been studied by a monitoring method. Finally, you will know about the results of research by specially considering of the floor heaving. That's what I am going to talk about today. I hope that you will hear your ideas and comments. Now, I'd like to tell you a few words about Bakuo mine. This mine is a part of state enterprise Donetsk Coal Energy Company. The mining area is located in the western part of Donetsk and Makeyevka geologic industrial district of Donetsk Basin in Ukraine. The mining area of this property is 30 square kilometers. The strike length is 8.5 kilometers and 3.5 kilometers of the deep. Bakuo mine is currently operating in the M3 coal bed in the western flank of the mining area. The mine uses advancing and treating long-fall mining methods. Long-fall panels are mined out by using fully mechanized system. Nowadays, mine is long-falling in the 8th western long-fall M3 coal bed. Working depth is about 860 meters and a deep angle is 9 degrees. The long-fall panel is 1,100 meters long and 250 meters wide. The next slide describes development workings with protection support methods in the belt entry of the 8th western long-fall M3 coal bed. Drainage is carried out by drilling and blasting operations in advance of 5 meters. Support system is used in entries of 3-link yielding SVP profile by steel strengthen support for every half meters along the whole entry. Cross-section area is 16 square meters. A dirt filled chalk is 1.3 meters in width, and a hand-built dirt pack is 7 meters in width, were used to protect the entry. Floor heaving occurs in the belt entry of the 8th western long-fall M3 coal bed. When the entry is driven under high stress conditions, the cross-section area accelerates decreases. The amount of floor heaving in the mine was measured until as much as 2 meters along the entire length of belt entry. The slide illustrates it. The miners had to dig out the heaving rocks in the floor of the belt entry to keep the floor in order. This extra work resulted in spending time and labor costs. So, studies have been conducted to research this problem by instrumental and visual observations. It's made to find protection methods for controlling floor heaving in order not be faced within it again. Firstly, we study stratigraphic relationship for this condition. We use data of the geologic report of Bakuo mine. Throughout the long-fall area, M3 coal bed thickness is almost 1 meter. The M3 coal bed is medium bright and uniaxial strength is approximately 16.5 MPa. The mediate roof is gray to dark gray mudstone with lamination. Mudstone is generally from 7 to 10 meters thick and the uniaxial strength is just under 40 MPa. The mediate floor is dark gray sealstone with uniaxial strength is about 50 MPa and its thickness is just under 1.6 meters. Immediately beneath siltstone there is dark grey to brown limestone, which uniaxial strength is almost 110 MPa, and its thickness is nearly 0.4 meters. So, in this slide we see generalized stratigraphic column of the interburden in the floor which contains hard rocks. It's limestone and sandstone. Particularly, they are adjacent to siltstone. Secondly, we study floor heaving by a monitoring method. To establish a better understanding of extensive floor heaving, three monitor stations were built along the belt entry of the 8th Western Longfall M3 coal bed. The monitoring stations are located by 10 meters between. The monitoring station has been consisted of six marks. The mark of wooden rod has length 0.4 meters and diameter 0.03 meters. Marks were installed and drilled short holes in the center roof of entry and in its sides at a height of 2.5 meters from floor. The rest of marks were installed in the center and sides of floor entry, so that their top has been located down at a distance of 0.05 meters below the floor surface. On the end of each mark, a fixed steel hook is simply measured by a steel tape. Monitoring stations were used to measure the convergence in the height and width of the entry. A distance from the floor and roof marks to the middle line is schematically shown in a slide. Its line between sides marks made by a steel tape. Measurements were carried out in series twice a week. At the same time, floor displacement was measured by using three floor marks. There were entries hole side, center and drip side. Results were compared to choose the overall accuracy of the convergence between monitoring stations. Okay, let's have a look at the results of monitoring. The results of floor movement are given in this slide in terms of displacement and its rate depend on the phase distance. At the top of this diagram you see measure displacement on floor marks. At the bottom you see a rate of its displacements. There are a blue line is for half side floor mark, a green line is for central floor mark, and a red line is for rip side floor mark. Calculation rate of displacement was adjusted taking into account the phase by 50 meters per month. The graph shows that a flow movement increases in the rate of displacement along the phase distance and slows down up to 35 meters. The lifted flow is non-uniform in this peak of about. It's 2.5 meters from half side, 1.8 meters in the center and 1.3 meters from rip side. It's necessary to notice that the ripping was carried out at a distance of 35 meters from fall face. Its size reached a height to 1.2 meters for the half distance wide from entry's half side, but ripping was not made from entry's rip side. Three marks were repeatedly installed on floor. The results of monitoring made it possible to determine that the floor heaving was carried out according to the four stages. Next slide illustrates them. At the first stage, some bricks and halves producing numerous cracks were observed after the drainage of immediate floor. Floor displacement rate progressively increases non-uniformly along the entry wide. Thus, we have an inclination that increases up to 9 degrees. The completion of this means a cavity with brick up of the entry's half side floor from face advance at a distance of 7 meters. At the second stage, the increasing rate of floor displacement from a half side is established. There is an variability in the center and from a rip side as well. An angle of the floor inclination increases up from 10 to 25 degrees at this stage. An intensive extrusion of the immediate floor was observed on some sites starting from 7 to 25 meters of face advance. At the third stage, there is jumping rate of floor displacement from the face distance from 25 to 35 meters. Its maximum is approximately 0.17 meters per day. Thus, a wave displacement of the floor stratum with creation of longitudinal asymmetry and curvation at a distance of about 0.9 meters from the hove site was observed. Its vertical axis is tilted towards a hove site at an angle from 35 to 50 degrees. Floor displacement rate gradually decreased after the maximum achievement. The fourth stage begins at about 35 meters from face advance, and the entry does not satisfy with safety rules. Thus, it's made with the help of ripping and timbering where necessary. After that, insignificant growth at the rate of floor displacement is stabilized. Traditionally accepted methods of floor heaving control on mine is the ripping. But isn't enough only one ripping in that whole entry. That's why I need to do some practice of entry maintenance in the conditions of periodic rippings shows there's need to do retimbering of belt entry after two or three rippings. As I have already said, entry repair work is giving a rise to financial problems and labor costs. To sum up my speech, I'd like to tell you that we have considered results of this study in condition of Abakuau mine. It was revealed that floor heaving has occurred through four stages. They have been divided by features of floor movement and its deformation. The adopted protection support methods at Abakuau mine don't provide the belt entry of the ACE Western L5 M3 coil bed with stability. It is established that floor heaving occurs with a longitudinal asymmetry in curvation, which vertical axis is tilted towards the hoves at an angle from 35 to 50 degrees. Thus, it's more likely that the floor has to deform in order to establish hard rocks such as limestone and sandstone. It is unclear how a file mechanism works in the floor structure to the extensive floor heaving that results a hard stratum. Generally, there are two reasons for floor heaving. The first is the occurrence of high stresses within the floor rock, and the second is the loss of strength of the floor rock. The resulting floor heaving usually causes bricks and halves producing numerous cracks. It happens in condition of hard rocks which are adjacent to less hard immediate floor. In our opinion, it happens because of the anchorage between a pack and a hard stratum of limestone. Otherwise, it would be hard to explain the cavity with brick up. For a better understanding, a further research will be focused on the reasons and developing protection support methods for controlling floor heaving. That's all. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Wait, please. Thank you, good afternoon. Thank you, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Pozdrav Dev Studio. Yes. Thank you, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I have done with my colleagues. Thank you, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I will present the work which I have done. Thank you, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I will present the work I have done with my colleagues. Thank you, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Blin. Thank you, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Жесть. they work, this work, study for giving, блин, на все включить, куда я парюсь.